Chris. I hope you're all doing well. Yeah, I asked again and yeah, you responded and most of you wanted to see a topic about Rhodesia. Yeah. Before we begin, I'm very sure that in this video again I will say some stuff. And yeah, I hope that this video won't get deleted, but anyway, let's start. So Rhodesia, what was once known as Rhodesia, it was African country. And it was actually called Southern Rhodesia because the successor state of Rhodesia today is called Zimbabwe. Divided into North and South Rhodesia. The North was Zambia and the South was Zimbabwe. About a bit about the early days from 1250 until 1629, the area was renowned as a gold trade by Arabs who built numerous stone structures which have survived to this day. In 1834, the Nebele people arrived while fleeing from the Zulu leader Shaka, calling the area Metabele Land. In the 1880s, the British arrived in the form of Cecil Rhodes, British South Africa Company. In 1898, the name Southern Rhodesia was adopted. So Rhodesia was named after Cecil Rhodes. He was like a mining magnate. He was an entrepreneur, politician, and a very influential guy in the British Empire, at least according to my research. Southern Rhodesia became a self-governing British colony in 1923. And Northern Rhodesia, what is now called Zambia, was a British protectorate in 1924. After the Second World War, many European powers, they lost control of their colonies in Africa, like France. They lost the control of countries like Morocco, Algeria, Tunisia, Libya, and so on. And of course, Great Britain lost control of most of their former colonies, and so on. And they kind of were worried too that they will lose their state because, and now I'm gonna say something controversial. Many people in the old
Policies he destroyed the country.
confiscated all the farmlands owned by white people, and many white people were also killed. It's ignored by the media because, yeah, nobody cares about that. This is my opinion. Yeah, and Zimbabwe, the country formerly known as Rhodesia, had an hyperinflation like almost Weimar Germany level. Yeah, and when Mugabe died, his this successor, I believe it's called Emmerson Mnangagwa, and yeah, he said that he wants white farmers to come back to racist whatsoever. I'm just stating facts here. Yeah. If I offended you with that video, I apologize, but yeah, I'm just stating facts here. Yeah. Anyway, I hope you liked the video, and I see you guys next time. Stay safe, God bless, and take care. Bye-bye.